Hello folks, Everchanger here, and welcome back to more Okami. Last time, we did a lot of mini-games here in the Saiyan City area, and it did take quite a long time, but I do have to admit, those racing mini-games are probably some of my least favorite in the game. So you might disagree with me on this, but I'm not gonna apologize for the length of last episode just because I got them over with, and I'm very, very happy about that. Anyway, we are here to talk to the Emperor today. Hello, Wolf. I got hold of a very interesting treasure just recently. It's a valuable item that enables you to walk on water. If you had enough demon fangs, I might consider giving it to you. Well, it just so happens that in between episodes recently, I grinded up to 100 demon fangs so we could buy the water tablet. Come and visit me again when you have more demon fangs to swap. We might not, I'm not sure. Anyway, what we can do is we can come in here and equip this water tablet. I think I'm going to put it over the P spell. This item is very, very interesting. But speaking of weapons, we are going to be doing something pretty crazy and possibly foolish in this episode. We are going to be taking on a super boss. So before we leave town, I would like to make a few preparations. Yes, I can speak. I'm a little bit nervous about this one, to be honest. So we're going to head back out to the main area in town, and we are going to do a little bit of shopping. Alrighty, here we are in the Commoner's Quarter. Now, I should point out, if you're not confident in your abilities, I don't recommend doing what I am going to be doing in this episode until far later in the game. Like, if you're at the very end, maybe. Anyway, we're going to skip past right through here, and we would like to buy some stuff right here. First off, there is a new reflector that I mentioned last episode, the Trinity Mirror. I'm not going to be buying this just because I want the Blade of Kusanagi to have a little bit more screen time, but if you're not confident in your abilities and you want to do this fight now, I definitely recommend buying this immediately and leveling it up with gold dust. I recommend buying a lot of Exorcism Slip M's. I think I am going to stock up to have 20 of these, and I'm also going to buy, I think, about that many Steel Fist Sakes. In addition to that, I would like to hop into my praise right here, and I would like to upgrade my health once. And I would like to do that twice, but I do know a place where we can get some praise pretty soon here that'll put us over the top. Anyway, with that, I would like to head out to the dojo on Ryoshima Coast. Alrighty, here we are at the dojo. So you've come again, my little lupine friend. Have you come to sharpen your skills? Yes, indeed I have. Still don't recommend buying Fleetfoot. I do recommend buying either Four Winds, Spirit Storm, or Three Shears, and upgrading them as accordingly, depending on which weapon you want to use for this fight. Personally, I would recommend a reflector with a sub-glaive, but I'm feeling a little bit stupid today, so we're going to be doing that. So I think I'm going to buy three shears right here to add another hit onto my glaive combo. So you once again choose to try your hand at the fighting arts. I suppose I have no choice. I'll do as you wish and allow you to enroll in my dojo. But I must warn you, I won't hold back this time. Ah, ooh. I really always love this little cutscene. It's always just, it's just really funny to see. Anyway, once he has spun his little head around. Wah, are you mentally prepared to handle the ultimate challenge? Step inside to test your might. Indeed we shall. Let the lesson begin. We'll practice the Three Shears Glaive technique. Take these tips to heart and remember them as we train. First, swing the Wii Remote to begin the attack. Swing the Wii Remote rapidly in succession. Time it well. Repeat until you connect three consecutive glaive hits. You might have noticed, you can really only chain together two up to this point, but now we can do three. Tilt the Wii Remote up and hold for a more powerful charged attack. Devastating attacks become possible with this technique. Slice the enemy into ribbons. Slash the enemy in two. Use your new technique to teach the evil ones a lesson. Well, did you understand? I don't know, I think it's pretty simple enough. Ah, very well then. I'll grant you this technique scroll. Check it when you forget what it means to be a warrior. Like I'd ever forget, good sir. Understand it with your body as well as your mind. En garde. So what we want to do is we want to charge up our glaive, and then one, two, three. It's a little hard to pull off. I have to say the glaive is a little hard to control. Come on. One, two, three. It's a little wonky, but there we go. I did it. It's nice to have at least the ability to do it, even though it's a little hard to pull off. Not bad. Keep it up. I don't know. That was a lot worse than I would have hoped. So yes, you can stay here and practice to earn another Holy Bone M, but I just bought a whole bunch, so I'm just gonna leave. Had enough, eh? Listen, Wolf, gaining experience in a single skill is admirable, but you must never lose the drive for self-improvement. I pray that you do not forget that. Anyway, now that we are done here in the dojo, we are going to be heading over to the city checkpoint. Now, I just remembered there are a couple of interesting little details over here by Onkoku Temple that you might not have noticed. One of these graves says something interesting. I bet this untended grave is where the real Busty Babe's soul lies. May she and her two bouncy friends rest in peace. Oh, Isun, Isun, Isun. But anyway, that's a pretty commonly known detail, but one that is not nearly as commonly known and is much, much more morbid in nature. You might recall there was a body in the well back here when we followed the ghost of Rao to the palace. I want to go examine that again really quick. Oh man, these old bones are all that's left of the real Busty Babe. Poor thing, left out here like that all this time. May she rest in peace. Eerie indeed, probably one of the darkest things in this entire game. Anyway, with that, to the city checkpoint. Alrighty, here we are back at the city checkpoint. Didn't think we'd come back here again, but here we are. Anyway, there is one stray bead in this area that we never got, and indeed, you are required to have the power of the almighty water tablet to get it. Yeah, check this out. We can literally run on water, no strings attached. It's amazing. Anyway, what we want to do is somewhere in this area, we want to head all the way up. Actually, I think it's the other direction, derp, but I'm not going to cut around because it's so cool that you can just run on water. That's amazing. What we want to do is we want to run all the way up to the source of this river right here, because you might have noticed, but the current up here actually gets pretty powerful, believe it or not. And in fact, at some point up here, it will become impossible to draw water lilies. They'll just become completely washed away. There's no other way to get up here except with the water tablet. And if we go all the way out here to the absolutely very end, there is indeed a little island that doesn't actually appear on the map, and there is something over here that we definitely want to grab. So all the way out here, there is of course a tree to bloom, which I did in one try, which is great. 11 praise is a little bit of a random number. And there is also a clover, which I believe dishes out a whopping 50 praise. Am I correct about that? 5? For this thing, you need the water tablet to come out here. Are you serious? Okay. And right here, buried on the island, is indeed a stray bead. Very nice. Anyway, there is one other area in the game, I believe, that you're required to have the water tablet to get to, and it is actually over in Agata Forest. This is a completely optional thing, not like a stray bead or anything like that, but I think I am going to show it now. Alrighty, here we are in Agata Forest, the only other place in the game that really has raging rapids that will probably kill you if you jump in them. Also, one thing I'm not sure I mentioned a long while ago is if you use wind on these grass piles, they will actually blow away and you can find treasure underneath them, so I recommend going back to a lot of older areas to try this out. Free Holy Bone M right here, which is pretty nice, probably could have used that a while ago. Anyway, we can now jump in the rapids and run all the way down here. Or is it the other way? Must be the other way. One of the ways down here actually has something that you probably want to grab because it's a decently good reward, even though it's not required for 100% or anything like that. Let's see, where is it? It's around here somewhere. Aha! Right here! there is a very cleverly hidden clover. This one is special. Watch what you get for blooming this thing. 50 praise. Yeah, really, really insane reward right here. So what I want to do is I want to come in here and I want to upgrade my health again. Also, it's worth noting, you might want to upgrade your Astral Pouch because this is the first time in the game where I feel like it's reasonably possible that you would actually die. What am I talking about right here? Well, we're going to be heading to Kusa Village next, and I'll explain a little bit more once we get there. Alrighty, here we are in Kusa Village. Now, there is something up here that I actually forgot to show the first time we were here that I feel like I really should. You see that long pathway over there? That's where we want to go. It's a little weird how we get up there, but I believe what we do is we can come over this way, and eventually one of those Konohana blossoms will open up. And I also noticed this area is very, very orange, even in the daytime. A little weird, but I mean, it's pretty cool. I'll go for it. I want to head right across this bridge, and is there a treasure on this little part? I don't think there is. So we want to vine our way all the way up to the top of this thing, which isn't too terribly hard, in my opinion, but anyway, there is the third one. I'm going to vine over there. And I could have shown this a long, long time ago. I just completely forgot. Also, I'm going to feed these monkeys, since I'm probably never going to be up here otherwise. Probably get a little bit of praise from these guys. Nothing too major. Yeah, 6 praise. That's pretty good. And what do you have to say? Ah, it's wonderful to feel a nice breeze blowing again. And I can't tell you how happy I was to see the windmill start up. Princess Fusei is amazing, ousting that Crimson Helm brute like that. Really? Now Kusa Village can sleep easy again at last. Wait, he has more to say? Okay. I wonder if I'll be able to spot that floating island in the sky. My grandpa said there's a land up there called the Celestial Plain. That's where all the great gods are supposed to live. I don't know, though. It's all a bit far-fetched, if you ask me. That is actually a very, very plot-relevant line coming up here decently soon. Anyway, you want to be careful walking across this thing, as you can tell. And you'll notice, right up here, there's actually a blockhead and a clover hidden over here, apparently. Didn't actually know you could get up here, but let's grab this, since it's actually pretty out of the way. Probably only going to give, like, 5 or 10, but, I mean, it's worth a shot. Yeah, 5. Nothing too major. Anyway, hop down here carefully. Alrighty. Gaha! I am Blockhead. I guard this place so that all shall pass. Wait, I mean, none shall pass. Hey, haven't I seen you before? What are you talking about? I am the one and only Blockhead. And those who would claim otherwise are in for it. Are you trying to break through my airtight defense? Ha! Impossible! Nothing can harm this body of mine. Of course, there are those weak points of mine. A clean blow there would slay me in an instant. But I wouldn't be foolish enough to expose such a weakness. Now be on your way. None shall pass. As you can probably tell by the fact that this guy only has, like, what, 3 weak points? 4 weak points. You are not intended to do this as late as I am. Huh? Were my weak points so obvious? I have failed, but let it be known I died a warrior's death. Yeah, you really could have done this as soon as right after the Gale Shrine, I believe. But yeah, I just forgot. I'll be completely honest, I forgot. There's nothing of major importance in here. There's a couple of treasures and a couple of clovers, but other than that, really not a big tragedy that I missed it, because there's no Stray Bead or Sun Fragment or anything like that. Anyway, pan the camera around. Did we only get the one? Yeah, we only got the one. What the heck? Alright. Anyway, there we go. Nice little extra 10 praise. Anyway, with that, now on for that super boss fight. We are going to the Gale Shrine. But first, I highly, highly recommend you. That's death? Oh. Anyway, I highly recommend you save, and now, in my case, heal. Alrighty, now that we have saved and healed, we are back here in the Gale Shrine, and you might recall there was one stray bead that we never ever got, and in fact, this is the earliest point where you are capable of going to get this stray bead. Again, if you are not very confident in your abilities, like I sort of am, I would definitely recommend saving this until much later in the game. In fact, possibly all the way up until right before the final boss. That's how insane this can be. In fact, I'd argue that this might even be harder than the final boss. Hey, Princess Fusei, how's it going? Are those 5 canine warriors falling in line? They look awfully bored. You sure they're even awake? Why, it's the White Wolf and Little Bug. How nice of you to return to the Gale Shrine. I've been waiting for you. You have? I have trained the remaining canine warriors. Introducing the new Satomi canine warriors, the Kusa 5. Rain or shine, they shall battle monsters and all their evil. Here in Taka Pass, none can match their power. Please test the power of the Kusa 5 for yourselves. Huh? Pretty please? It would be an honor to have the Bane of Crimson Helm and Orochi battle against the Kusa 5. Haha. Well, if you put it that way. But first, there is something I must mention. The Kusa 5 is a tough, battle-hardened group. They won't hold back once the match begins. Once their honor is on the line in fierce battle, I would not be surprised if one of you fell in battle. The Kusa 5 is at least 10 times more powerful than Orochi. This will be a life or death struggle. You must prepare to face a battle unlike any you've seen before. Will you accept the challenge? That's a dumb question. You really think this stubborn wolf would back down? Right, Ami? We gonna do this death match, or what? One last warning. Even though this is available the instant you clear Oni Island, I would recommend you wait before you do this unless you are very confident in your abilities or would just really like a challenge, because this is a challenge. Anyway, in my case, I'm scared. No, bring it. Excellent. Oh, faithful canine warriors, members of the Kusa 5, prepare to face the invincible White Wolf and Little Bug. Let's make it a fair and clean fight. Anyway, there's an interesting little glitch right here in the Wii version. It displays the image of the Wind Doom Mirror instead of the image of the canine warriors. Anyway, I'm going to bring up my brush right here to just glance over at my notes and say the first round of this fight is versus Rei, Shin, Chi, and Ko. Yes, there are 4 canine warriors in here, and I definitely recommend ample use of Veil of Mist to dish out some damage to these guys, because if they gang up on you, it can get really bad really quick. As you can tell, I've already lost all of my godhood, and they all have that crazy charge-up attack. Anyway, going to be making use of my sub-rosary just to shoot off some firing rods right here. Rods? I don't even know what that's supposed to mean. Anyway, as you might recall, to fire off rapid fire on most rosaries, you have to press Z and then mash C for quick firing, which is a very helpful thing to keep in mind. Also, I highly, highly recommend stocking up on Infinity Stones if you don't have too many to go around. I also would argue that this fight is almost nearly impossible if you do not have the Golden Ink Pot, just because you are going to be using your ink a lot in this fight. Anyway, these first fights are a little crazy just because there are 4 canine warriors here. I definitely recommend using your brush skills as much as you can, but definitely using your weapons, and especially ranged weapons in this case, is a very, very smart idea. Anyway, gonna smash these guys with a little bit of glaive power, And this fight is probably going to take a little bit. Normally I would speed it up, but considering this fight, pretty much anything can happen really quickly. I don't want to speed things up just in case something crazy happens, because knowing this fight, it just darned well might, because this is, again, one of the most difficult fights in the entire game. Luckily, I've managed to not take damage yet, which is a little surprising to me, but I mean, I will definitely take it, and I've managed to build up quite a bit of godhood right here. And building up your godhood and keeping it up is definitely good, so I'd recommend godly charms and the stuff like that as well to keep your godhood up, just because that basically gives you some free hits, which is definitely very nice. Also, I recommend going into your tools whenever you can and using these exorcism slips, because once you do that, it will stun all of them and open them up for Power Slash, and you definitely want to make use of that at every opportunity you can. Alrighty, dealing a little more damage to these guys right here. I'm actually doing decently well, which I'm not wanting to jinx, but I think I'm doing okay considering the circumstances of how hard this boss fight is, and I just lost a layer of godhood, which is a little disappointing. Alrighty, and I lost another one. I'm getting a little greedy right here with my attacks. I definitely want to be careful right here. Alright, gonna let my ink charge up, just keep out of harm's way. And honestly, I would not recommend attacking if you don't have Veil of Mist right here, because their attacks launch very, very quickly, and they can catch you off guard incredibly easy. As you can see right there, I even had Veil of Mist up, and that attack came out very quickly. Looks like one of them stunned. Gonna slash them right there, and bring up another Veil of Mist. And the glaive is actually working out for me. I'm pretty impressed with how well this is working. Anyway, once they do get low down on health, it is worth mentioning, I don't think these guys have floral finishers even now, and I think I almost got hit right there, which would have been definitely bad. Alright. Ooh, I just got hit. Ow. Ow. I got hit twice. That is kind of... Ooh, I just got hit three times, man. Like, yeah, you see what I'm saying? These guys can pull out some serious, serious firepower at very... very short notice, and you definitely want to be mindful of the risks involved, especially when attacking close range. And ow, ay ay ay. All right, can we get some rapid fire going, getting up some godhood? I'm pretty sure godhood goes up when you are dealing damage and not getting hit. I think that's just the natural assumption right here. So if you are in dire straits, I recommend trying to go a long time without getting hit and just being very, very safe with your attacks. Otherwise, you might get in a bit of a bind. Anyway, now that we've done that, I think I'm going to use another exorcism slip. And I have to say, there's no harm in using these things in a fight this hard. It might seem cheap at first, but honestly, it's definitely worth the free attack just because it's insane what these guys can pull out at very short notice. Also, be very, very mindful of your ink, because if it runs out, you are going to be in trouble. I'm just gonna scribble right here and, like, make sure that doesn't actually take, just because I want to keep my ink. Because, as a reminder, if your ink runs out, your divine instruments also disappear, which means you are very, very weakened when at a lack for ink. Alright, gonna take a couple more pot shots right there. Gonna want to keep out of that attack, and I think one of them is very close to being down. I think it's the one wearing purple. I don't know which one that is specifically, like what their name is, but I think he's pretty close. You definitely want to get him down like that. Gonna do a little cheap slash right there, even though I know these guys don't have floral finishers. Alright, gonna get a couple more hits in, and that one is charging up a melee attack. Definitely want to be careful with that. Alright, this one's pretty close to being down, and ow, that hit for a lot. Yeah, these attacks definitely hit for a lot, and that's gonna hit again. Ooh, yay, yay. Alright. I don't think I'm actually in need of using a Holy Bone yet, but you definitely want to have a good stock of those Holy Bones, otherwise you are going to be in trouble. Ooh, boy. Alrighty. And I do have to say, this is probably the most difficult fight we are going to be doing until right up before the final boss, where we start doing some of the other difficult optional fights in this game. So this is easily the most challenging fight in the game we're going to be doing until right up near the end. Alright, please don't lurch at me yet. Oh boy. Alright, charge up that glaive one more time. Alright, that pinkish lavender one is pretty close to being down. There we go. Alright, there's only one dog left. Gonna move out of the way of this one's crazy attack. Wait, that still hits me even if I'm not, like, in front? Okay, that's a little bit cheap, but I mean, I guess I'll take it. A couple more pot shots right there with our beads. Alright. Charge up, and that's gonna hit. Ooh boy. Alright. Alright, this guy's pretty close to being down, I think. Since there's only one of them, it's a lot more manageable. I'd argue that this early fight, the very first round, is probably one of the more difficult ones just because there's four canine warriors in the arena with you, which is really, really quite insane. Anyway, this guy's almost down. Come on. Come on. Come on, we're almost there. We're almost there. There we go. Round one is completed. Anyway, once you have done that, we will be ranked probably very awfully on time and damage. Actually, that's not too terrible. And immediately, a battle will start with three more canine warriors. Surprisingly enough, these are Gi or Take, Jin or Ume, and Chu or Hayabusa, which are the ones that never actually returned to Kusa Village during its time of need. Anyway, you might notice these guys pack the digging attack, which is not fun. You do not want to get stuck in a hole with these guys. It's just bad news. Out of all of the rounds where I recommend using a exorcism slip, this is probably the one. You want to wait until they're all very close together, and then you can get a nice little pot shot power slash in on them. Then you can immediately go back to Veil of Mist and start taking more shots at them with your divine instruments. But yeah, out of all the rounds for using exorcism slips, I definitely recommend this one, simply because the hole digging and the dirt flying everywhere is a little bit rough if you get caught in one of these holes. Alright, hopefully this round won't be too terribly long compared to the first one, since there's only three of them. But again, they are packing some more attacks that you might not be expecting, since it's been quite a while since we've actually fought any canine warriors, period. Alright, gonna get some more hits on these guys, and I'm not really very good at launching the three shears attack, but I mean, it's nice to have because I do plan on buying all of the techniques by the end of the game. I will be buying Fleetfoot right at the end just to show how it works, but I really don't want to buy it during the main LP just because it literally interferes with your ability to do fights in this game because of how unresponsive the nunchuck gyroscope is. Alright, we got these guys about down a third, which is not bad. No, no, I got stuck in the hole. Oh yeah, they can hit you for a lot of damage when you're in here. I think I'm going to use an exorcism slip, and you know what, we got like a ton of Holy Bone S's. I'm just going to use those and then pull out Exorcism Slip M on these guys and get that slash attack right in. Did I hit all of them with one shot? I think I did. Anyway, Veil of Mist again, and this probably explains better why I think Veil of Mist is my favorite power, because not only is it a cool idea, uh-oh, I ran out of ink, that's no good. Not only is it a really cool idea, but it is so helpful in pretty much every fight you're going to be doing without exception. So, definitely, definitely use it. You want to keep Veil of Mist up pretty much constantly during some of these fights just because of how good it is at being able to dodge out of the way of attacks and just giving you more time to dish out your own attacks. Alright, more bead action right here, and unfortunately that one is charging up an attack, a very powerful one. Hayabusa, stop, we're friends, we're the digging champ, remember? Aye. Alrighty. Alright, gonna get another Veil of Mist up right here, and I think this fight is actually going quite well compared to how I honestly expected it to go before this. Pretty much every LP of this game on YouTube doesn't do this boss fight until much, much later, and I was afraid I was going to have a lot of trouble, But this is actually going decently well, and they're all right next to each other, so I think it would be remiss of me not to do the exorcism slip trick. Alright, so we're gonna blast them all down there, give them a good slash to the face. Alrighty. Anyway, gonna bring up Veil of Mist one more time. And it looks like Ume is actually pretty close to being down, which is nice. It'll definitely be nice to get one of them off the field. I do recommend, in general, targeting one above the others just because getting one off the field is immensely helpful, like we have done just there. So now there are only two of these mutts to deal with. Alrighty. Gonna get another Veil of Mist up, and I'm very close to running out of ink right here, which has me a little nervous, but I think we can make this work. Alright, I'm gonna keep out of their way as much as I can. Let's see, can we get a nice glaive shot in there? There we go. More mist. And wow, he jumped out of the way. That was a pretty good dodge there, buddy. I'm not gonna lie. Props to you. Alright. Really, really would like to get one of them to lose all of their color, but I'm not sure if I'm actually gonna get that opportunity. Alright, anyway, Hayabusa's pretty low here, so I think we're gonna focus on him just to get him off the field as much as quickly as we can. Oh no, I'm in the hole. That's bad. And I can't actually open the menu while I'm in the hole, which is amusing. You might have noticed they have a little attack right there where if you're in the hole, they will walk up and, like, I don't know, pee on you, and that causes your ink to go down, which I know, Japan and all that, but yeah, it's just a thing that you have to be aware of. Anyway, with that, down goes Hayabusa, and now Take is the only one left for us to deal with. So once again, having just one of these guys on the field is super, super nice. Alright, unfortunately he's charging up his crazy attack. Gonna get a cheap shot on him before he launches that. And bam, bam, bam. Alright, he's almost down. He's almost down. And of course he's gonna launch one more of those crazy attacks just because he can. And one other thing I really like about Veil of Mist is it allows you to really appreciate the level of detail in the character and enemy animations in this game, because they put a lot of work into it. Anyway, with that, down goes round two. Now round three, oh boy, round three is gonna be insane, because it is none other than a one-on-one against Tay. Now watch how fast that attack comes out. He is insane, and in fact, they are playing a boss fight song for this, because he's just that powerful. So yeah, you definitely want to keep on top of this guy as much as possible, and I also recommend using exorcism slips liberally in this round. And in fact, he's actually immune to exorcism slips unless he has just finished off attacking and things like that. If he's like got one of his attacks going out, you have to be careful. Let's see, can I get one to go off right now? I'm gonna only use an S just in case it doesn't work. Alright, that one worked. It seems to have done a little damage, but it didn't actually stun him, which is insane. I don't think we've seen an enemy prior to now that was that immune to exorcism slips. And as you can see, he does a ton of damage. And you'll notice when he jumped right there, his jumps actually deal damage all on their own, which is insanity. And look at how slowly his HP is going down. It's ridiculous how much this guy can dish out on you if you are not prepared. Like, Tay means freaking business. This is easily one of the most difficult one-on-one fights in the entire game, bar none. It's insane. Alright, gonna deal some more close-range shots on him right here. Definitely want to keep out of his way. Bring up more Veil of Mist. Alright, you see that right there, how he jumps and it is glowing right there? That is actually something of note that you'll want to keep in mind for later when we get some more dojo techniques open up to us. And I just love how I pronounce techniques there, but I'll be honest, I'm like all super tense right now because of this fight, because this is insane, this fight. Alrighty, definitely want to keep my godhood up. In fact, I might use a holy bone here just to keep my HP up, because this guy can deal damage quickly. Alright, did we actually get the stun off on him? No, we did not, and that did like a pixel of damage. Ow, man. Oh, crap. Yeah, as you can see, this guy is no joke. Let's see, what am I gonna do? I'm gonna use those Steel Fist Sakes to increase my attack power. I haven't been using them all that much because I've been pretty confident, but in this particular round, I definitely recommend using them because they make a decent difference. I don't know off the top of my head how long they actually last for, though, so definitely keep that in mind. I believe there's a little golden trail by me. Oh my gosh, that did a lot of damage. So definitely worth keeping in mind, and I think listening closely, it actually does a bit of a sound effect while it's going on, so keep your ear out for that sound effect, otherwise you might be in for a surprise when it wears off and you're not expecting it. Oh boy. Alright, definitely keep that Veil of Mist up as much as we can. Gonna wail on this guy, and ooh, we want to get out of dodge of that immediately. Yeah, this attack goes so fast, so you definitely want to keep out of the way of that. Alright, charging up the glaive again. I think our sake just wore off, so I am going to use another one just to get my power up. Alrighty. Now, I believe Tay also has the ability to dig holes, although I don't believe we've seen him do it yet, which is interesting, but if you do happen to get him to do that, he's not going to walk up to you and do that ink draining attack. Instead, what he'll do is he will just unleash his fury on you. Like, just crazy, crazy powerful attacks, and falling into one of this guy's holes is a death wish if you manage to do it, if you know what I'm talking about. Alright, anyway, he's almost down. These sakes are really, really helping, and it's going to be nice to have some of my leftover stuff on hand in the future. But anyway, I think with one more attack... Oh no, we're in the hole. That's bad. Oh boy, as you can see, he took out all of my godhood there immediately. But with that, we have almost won. Ooh, wow, I actually died. I've never seen that before, so I guess we get to see what happens when the Astral Pouch kicks in. Yeah, as you can see, insane stuff, and I was so close too, like seriously, one more hit. But I mean, I guess it's a good thing that I was able to show how that works, and since I killed him in midair, we got an interesting animation too. And even with all that punishment, I didn't get the worst rank on damage. Hey. Enough. What magnificent techniques you have. You are most worthy of my praise. Nah, we probably just got lucky this time. Anyway, was it just me, or did I see the other three join in too? Indeed you did, for even when apart, their hearts beat as one. In their hour of need, the other canine warriors appear. So then, where were they during the Crimson Helm battle? Well, you see, in any event, it is now clear, the White Wolf and Little Bug shall forever be the standard for which the Kusa 5 aim. Thank you for your most excellent guidance. The Satomi House shall continue keeping the peace. And you get 48 praise for that, which is good. Now, my friends, please accept this as a token of the Satomi House's friendship. As long as you bear this, you shall have our eternal goodwill. And we get a very, very hardly earned stray bead. Now, it's worth noting, that was the first time I did that fight this early, and as you can tell, doing it this early is pretty insane, because we actually died and had to use the Astral Pouch, which is an animation that, I'll be honest, I've never seen before in this game, from myself or anyone, so YouTube first, maybe? Anyway, the look of delight on Princess Fusei's face was extra special. Yeah, I know what you mean. They all have unique things to say to you. It was great fun battling against you. Come and play with us again. You hear that, Ami? We have some new playmates. Practice makes perfect. I do not want to lose, no matter what. I get it, okay? Now, will you just relax? I'm so tired from all that training day after day. But I'm awake now that I've seen such power. Huh? Kinda late now. Our battle was a great experience for me. I shall now forge my mind and body in a bid to surpass you. You hear that, Furball? This flea bag's got guts. Anyway, with that, there are a couple more stray beads I do want to grab off in North Ryoshima Coast, but don't worry, they are very, very easy compared to that one, so I will meet you guys right over there. Alrighty, here we are on North Ryoshima Coast. Now, in episode 30, I believe it was, we obtained a treasure box from the Dragon Palace, and indeed, we are going to be making use of that today, because it does actually do something, it's not just for show. What we want to do is we want to head over to this house. And inside is Urashima. We want to speak to him. There you are, Pooch. Looking pleased with yourself, huh? But never mind that. You know that demon island out in the sea? It disappeared in a cloud of petals before my very eyes. And the water dragons calmed down too. Something's good about to happen. I'm sure of it. Howdy there, Pooch. Y'all make it to the Dragon Palace? I reckon you're pleased as a tick in a dog pound now that that awful demon island done gone away, huh? This guy's accent, hey. And if we give him the treasure box, there's really no indication that he wants this, but this is indeed what it is for. Well, I'll be. If it ain't that treasure box I've been looking for. Y'all went to the Dragon Palace to get this for me? Thank you. Thank you kindly. That time I drowned, they revived me at the Dragon Palace, see? That's why I'm stuck in a body that just won't get any older. I'll always look like a youngin', forever and ever. Remember what that attendant said about opening the treasure box? Meanwhile, everyone around me's getting older and older. But with this treasure box, I reckon I can return to normal. Phew. Well, how do I look? Honey, is that really you? It sure is. Your husband's back. You're back. You've finally come back to me. And I'm here to stay. I ain't going nowhere. I'll never leave you again, dear. And for that, we get 20 praise. I don't know how I can ever thank you enough. But I want y'all to have this. It ain't much, just a token. I found this pretty stone on the seabed. It brought me luck, see? And we get a stray bead, and yes indeed, Urashima is actually an old man. Oh boy. Anyway, with that, that's just a little teeny detail to get a stray bead, and there is yet one more I want to grab in the Dragon Palace. Now, I should mention this really quick. There is a reward in the game for dying, I believe, less than 4 times. So if you die a lot on that Canine Warrior fight, I recommend just quitting without saving, which is why I recommend saving before doing that fight, because otherwise you'll miss out on a pretty neat reward. I don't want to spoil anything, but yeah, I thought I'd point that out. Anyway, we want to talk to Otohime right here. Your deeds shall never be forgotten at the Dragon Palace. Glory to the great god Amaterasu. Why, Amaterasu, it's so good to see you. What tidings do you bring? You okay, babe? I mean, that was one heck of a feat you pulled off. You had me worried. I had no choice but to perform the rite of transformation. Such traditions are normally reserved for kings. But the people of our realm have accepted me as their ruler. Henceforth, I devote my life to protecting our people and the sea. All hail Queen Oto! We shall follow her wherever her majesty leads. This is a little bit weird, because her name is Otohime, right? Well, it turns out the Hime suffix in her name actually means queen or some other royalty modifier, so that's what the reasoning for that is. Glory to the Dragonians! Speak to her again. Amaterasu, there was something more I wish to tell you. I carry the child of my dearly departed husband, King Wada. I have every hope our child shall grow up to be a fine leader, and maybe someday even king or queen of the Dragonians. We Dragonians shall protect the sea for all eternity. All hail, Queen Oto! We shall follow wherever Her Majesty leads. Glory to the Dragonians! I know not how I shall ever thank you for what you have done. This could never begin to repay my debt to you, but please accept it as a token of my eternal gratitude. Indeed, talking to Otohime twice after clearing Oni Island will net you a basically free stray bead. That's actually all I wanted to show in this area, so I think, with that all out of the way, we want to open up the way to the Great North, so we are heading off to Shinshu Field. Alrighty, here we are warped back to Shinshu Field, and I do again have to apologize because I'm pretty sure this video is also pretty long in length, although I think it's pretty explainable because that fight against the Kusa Five is insane, but I do have to just at least acknowledge the length of this video because it's kind of crazy. Some of the videos going forth are going to be a little bit long just because I'd like to get a lot of side quests out of the way and yet still feel like we've gotten something done because a lot of the side quests are a bit time consuming in this game. Anyway, right up here, this has been here for ages, but nobody knows what it's for. There are many things like that in Nippon. No one knows when they were built or even who built them. But I suppose people have more important things to think about. Yes, indeed, very interesting stuff. At first glance, it does look like this is some sort of observatory, which is interesting. Anyway, right here, another nice little treasure for us to get. And if we pan around, you can see that there is lightning right here, and also a bit of a sword right here. You know what we do with that, right? Indeed, we have now opened up a path, and it points towards those twin peaks in the distance that we could see during that cutscene. What is the significance of those twin peaks right over there? Perhaps next time we will find out. So, this past episode of Okami, we did quite a few side quests, although the main highlight was definitely the battle against the Kusa Five. And next time on Okami, we are going to be heading through the path we opened to the Frigid North. So without further ado, thank you all for watching, and I will see you guys next time.